All right, gang, welcome to Hansens Speed Shop. Today we're going to tackle a question that I get asked all the time. Where can I get a old muscle bike or old Schwinn banana seat bike or something like that? Where can I find one and how can I get one cheap? Because usually if you do find one, they're expensive. So that's what we're going to talk about today. All right, guys, so the biggest advice that I can give you is just keep your eyes open and look everywhere, because these things pop up everywhere. So, you know, keep your eyes out, check like thrift stores, secondhand stores, antique stores, garage sales, you know, flea markets, swap meets, all that kind of stuff's where you're gonna find these old bikes. If you don't really have access to any of that, try looking on Craigslist, try looking on Marketplace, and then, you know, of course, eBay. But if your only resort is eBay, you're gonna want to start saving up your pennies now, because you're gonna need a lot of them, because probably not gonna find too many good deals on eBay. But this right here is a perfect example. This was a complete 1970 Schwinn Stingray Jr. that I just picked up. Now this is 2021, you gotta remember that. I just picked this up like roughly a month or so ago at an antique store, one of my favorite antique stores to go to, because they always got like really cool stuff, from car parts and motorcycle parts to old bicycles and old toys, and they always get like new stuff in every week. But this was sitting out front and it wasn't in good shape, trust me, but $35 for a whole complete Schwinn Stingray. So that was a good deal. So I mean, even though we are to 2021, these old bikes are still out there and you still can find them cheap. Now, we completely stripped this thing down. I gave it to my dad because he's going to do something with it. I just got it for him because he needed some parts. Well, then he decided he was just going to do the whole bike up. But even as it was, I mean, the wheels were shot, the tires were shot, pretty much everything. This bike would probably sat outside for like 50 years or something. So everything kind of looked like how this kickstand looks. Still, even if you were to throw like $100, $150 at it, you could have had a nice rideable bike for not a lot of money, and you know, have a real vintage piece of Americana, a real Schwinn. So they are out there, and they can be found, and you can get good deals on them. So you just gotta look, you gotta put in the work, and you gotta look, and you know, you'll come across something. They are, you know, it is an achievable thing. I get a lot of questions from young people too, which is really awesome. It really makes me happy, because that's why I do this, to inspire people. Like, man, that's really cool, I'd love to have one, that looks like fun, but I can't find one or I can't afford one. Well, my advice is you just gotta do the work and you gotta look, and if you look hard enough, you'll find it. And you know, and another thing is, just ask around. You'll be surprised. If you just start asking around, somebody might have something in their garage or, you know, their shed out back or whatever, and they just want to get rid of it. But, you know, just start looking, start asking around, and stuff pops up. All right, guys, if you got any questions, leave a comment below. If you dig this or you want to check out more stuff, go hit up the channel. There's tons of cool stuff to check out over there. There's more stuff on the way. Hit that subscribe button. Otherwise, until next time, guys, get out, work on your own projects, get those hands dirty and greasy, stay cool, and we'll catch you cats on the next one. Thanks for watching.